Like somebody said one time, it's got to be something in the water here in Texas, especially Southeast Texas, when it comes to great singer-songwriters. Long line of great singer-songwriters from our neck of the woods. And from just north of here, Lyndale. Yeah, that's where Miranda Lambert was raised. She was born in Tyler, raised in Lyndale. Her dad was a police officer. Lyndale's like 3 hours away from Beaumont, 210 miles to be precise, 210.3 for those of you keeping track. Anyway, Miranda Lambert and soul singer Leon Bridges will be releasing a new duet on June 6th. It's called If You Were Mine, and you can listen to a sample of it right now. No extra charge. Conley on King's Country, kingscountry.net. Jim King of the radio behind the wheel, driving you through the midday. Cadillac style's how we roll. I bet John Conley has a Cadillac or two. That's why I'm having a fabulous flashback. Gonna be a smooth ride. Hold on tight.
King of the road.
Backstage in Beaumont with country legend John Conley.
Former DJ, you did quite a few years on the behind the mic, didn't you?
9 years in radio altogether, seven of the nine in Nashville. That's what brought me to Nashville, is to because I got a job at a station there. And that's what allowed me to turn what was my hobby, music, into a career.
It surprises a lot of people to know that Rose-Colored Glasses wasn't actually a number one song, but it's what you're remembered for most, even though it wasn't your... You've had other number one songs. I think that was the top three or something.
Seven. It's top seven in Billboard. But it's still the most popular song we've ever done. It's a standard in music. And that underlines the unimportance of number one sometimes. Number one is an indicator that everybody in the industry follows. The fans don't take the trades. They don't care. They either love it or they don't. And if every song that I'd done in the meantime could be as popular as Rose... I would have them all stop at seven.
There must be a lot of luck involved in getting a number one song to get all those stations on board at the same time.
That is the key. All stations have to play it at once. That's why Rose didn't go number one. It started in one region, went up everybody's charts. Then the next region picked up on it. It was new to them. So in order to have a number one record, you got to have the whole country at the same time. And that's the reason it never went number one. Technical reasons that nobody cares about.
Well, I know you got to get back on the road, so we don't want to keep you any longer.
All right, good to see you again.
Good to see you, John Conley, everybody.
Thanks.
He's been working all week. He's got mental fatigue. And that old cow sure looks fine. All week he's been gone.
King's Country, kingscountry.net. It's a Thursday, June 1st, beginning of a new month. Always feels like a Friday to me since this is deadline day here at King of the Road Productions to turn in all my TV projects that I do each week, including the Jim King of the TV show. Got a preview coming up. Today is June 1st, Thursday, June 1st. It's 33 days to Independence Day, 17 days to Father's Day. Oh, and in 33 days when it becomes Independence Day, that is the day we launched King's Country way back in 2011. So do the math. That makes 12 years. Coming up on July 4th. Today is also Pen Pal Day and Say Something Nice Day. If you can, think of something. Here's a back-in-the-day tidbit for you. 59 years ago today, in 1964, the Rolling Stones arrived in New York to begin their first American tour. The first show was actually at a high school stadium in Lynn, Massachusetts. The Rolling Stones. Whatever happened to those guys? Streaming from the studio of King of the Road Productions on a Thursday that feels like a Friday to me, because it's crunch time at King of the Road Productions, where I turn in the Jim King of the TV show and a couple other projects that I work on each and every week. Glad to have the work. Good work if you can get it. Anyway, this weekend is episode number 877 of the Jim King of the TV show. Should be able to catch you for the first time tonight on Strike TV, 8 o'clock. You got the Roku app. You can watch in Beaumont. Just get the Strike TV Roku app. It's great stuff. 24/7 country channel. Anyway, in this episode this weekend, we're going to close it out with Jeff Bates. He'll be in the Royal Spotlight thanks to Glenn's Express Collision. We have the Southeast Texas debut of a Texan by the name of Brooke Graham's new video. She's from the Port Aransas area. Good singer, songwriter. Must be something in the water down there, too. Anyway, that's our Taylor Trading Company music clip of the week from Nashville. Of course, we'll have the Honky Tonk Texas Fabulous Flashback with Cody Johnson. And we'll kick it off with a couple of exclusive concert footage and interview segments with Cody Johnson, a.k.a. Kojo. Here's a sample.
I'd like to play y'all some brand new music that I'm going to record on my next album. Is that all right with y'all? I am a young, fixing to be 26 years old, and I'm stuck between a generational gap because I don't do the Facebook thing as well. When I was growing up, if you had a problem with somebody, you went over to their house, you knocked on their door, you got out in the yard, you knocked each other upside the head, you shook hands, and you moved on about it. Am I right? So after the election, I kind of had so many people talking trash about all this from both sides. I chose not to talk trash. I chose to do what the good Lord put me on this earth to do, and that's pick up my guitar, a pen, and a piece of paper, write down exactly what I was thinking. So this is my latest passion of a song. I hope you guys enjoy it. Down where I was raised, a handout ain't for men like us. That's what my daddy said. His words are true, and I don't believe them till I'm dead. So I sit here on my front porch, and I hear the whippoorwill cry for the long lost land of Dixie. Sweet by and by, and I can feel the winds of change now blowing hard on the back of my neck. I believe in the red and white and blue, but lately all I see is red.
You went to Nashville a couple of years ago, and you actually have a producer, Trent Willman.
Yes.
He had a song called Beer Money, didn't he?
Beer Man,
that's what it was.
On Again,
yeah.
Off Again tonight,
yeah.
At Dixie Rose Deluxe. He's a good friend of mine, a heck of a producer, even better songwriter and a better singer. And
mm-hmm.
He kind of took me under his wing. And since, you know, I've just signed a publishing deal out of Nashville and getting to write more for different artists. And mm-hmm. He's opened up more doors than I'll ever be able to repay.
You working on another studio album?
We're actually going back in the spring. We're going to go start recording. And I'm going to take a year to record. I messed up last time and kind of said, this is when the CD's going to be done. And then had to try to get it done.
Mm-hmm.
We're going to go take and let the creative just kind of flow out. See what we can. We've developed a sound over the year that's become more of a signature sound for us. And I think it's time we go spend some time in the studio and get to know that sound and kind of really, really hone it in. You know, we were listening to Chris LeDoux's live album today, and
mm-hmm.
you see so many similarities. I was thinking, man, guys, we need to kind of fill a little bit more of that out. And I'm excited about going to get and record this year, but we'll probably have it out by the end of the year, maybe.
Look away, Dixieland, look away, look away, Dixieland. So I sit here on my front porch, and I hear the whippoorwill cry for the long lost land in Dixie.
Comes this week's Honky Tonk Texas Fabulous Flashback. Your new album just did fantastic on the Billboard chart and the country charts. Debuted at number 2.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. And the new single, doing well, too?
Yes, sir. We've had With You I Am was our first single. It was kind of my... It's crazy because it was kind of my last choice on the song on the CD for a single, and it wound up being the first choice of the crowd. It kind of blew my mind. And I like getting outside my box, though. So there's the new single is called Wild As You, and it's the follow-up single to it. And, man, it's really taken. It's such a crowd-pleaser at the live shows.
Yeah.
I mean, it's just it's one of my favorite parts of the set, and you'll see that tonight, that when we kick off into that thing, it just kind of – you watch the crowd kind of explode. It's pretty cool.
And they'll be mouthing the words, I'm sure.
Oh, no, they'll be singing louder than me. The biggest problem I have nowadays is hearing myself. And it's not because I'm going deaf. It's because our crowds are so loud that every night we're trying to figure out how to get my voice louder than that in my ears. And what a cool problem to have.
New album's called Gotta Be Me, and you started way back when you were about 12 years old, I think, did you?
Yeah, I've been playing for a while. It's been a lifelong affair.
King of the Road. That was this week's Honky Tonk Texas Fabulous Flashback.
Check out the Kojo and Country episode of the Jim King of the TV show 3 times this weekend on Fox 4 and the CW. Also on Strike TV 3 times each week now. And thanks for streaming King's Country. King's Country, kingscountry.net. Jim King of the Radio driving you through the lunch hour on a Thursday. It always feels like a Friday now that it's crunch time here at King of the Road Productions. But never too busy to do this fun thing I like to do called the Jim King of the TV show, a radio show. Getting ahead of myself. That's tonight on Strike TV, first time, 8 o'clock tonight. Anyway, breaking news from Nashville for your dining and dancing pleasure in the lunch hour. Kimberly Perry's If I Die Young Part 2 was partially inspired by a miscarriage she had a few months before writing the new version. Here she is telling that sad story.
When we wrote Part 2, I had actually just gone through a miscarriage a few months before, which was a really sad time. So in writing the second verse, it was like, well, I would really love to set this intention that there is a baby coming, a healthy baby who's going to be here at some point. And it felt like it really held hands with the original version, because the entire original version was sort of this romantic plea for all the things that I was hoping for. A few months after we recorded the song, I found out I was pregnant.
Faster than a speeding bullet. More powerful than a locomotive. Able to leap tall buildings at a single bound. Look, up in the sky. It's a bird.
It's a plane.
King of the Road.
I'll say it again, and I'm the first one to say this. Neil the Real McCoy.
That is the most original thing I've ever heard. Congratulations.
I've been working on that all day, Neil. It's great to finally meet you, man. You have a reputation of being one of the most approachable, personable people in country music, and so far I believe it.
Well, good. Well, we're just
kicking me off his bus.
Well, we're just fixing to kick you out now, so you may want to retract that statement when you're out there filming by yourself. No, yeah, we think we're easy to talk to. We've always been that way, and I think if you just learned a long time ago, if you put on a good show every night and treat people nice, you can work a long time.
This concludes our special broadcast. We now return to Nothing Special.
King's Country, kingscountry.net. It's a Thursday that feels like a Friday. Jim King of the Radio behind the wheel, heading into the final hour of the Jim King of the Radio show for a, what is it? It's a Thursday. Yeah, all downhill to the weekend. We'll have another preview of this weekend's Jim King of the TV show. That's coming up in just a little bit. Don't miss it tonight on Strike TV. It'll air first time, 8 o'clock tonight. It's got Cody Johnson in this episode. As we keep them coming on King's Country. We're streaming from the studio of King of the Road Productions in Beaumont, Texas. Jim King of the Radio and TV behind the wheel today. And I do it on the television, too. First time tonight, 8 o'clock on Strike TV. I hope you're into streaming TV, because it's opened a new, whole new world to us since we got rid of our cable boxes and we're streaming exclusively here at King of the Road Productions in Suzanne Simmons' house. Anyway, so don't miss it this weekend and tonight. A Kojo and Country episode of the Jim King of the TV show. We've got some exclusive concert footage and interviews from our Royal Archives of Cody Johnson right here in Southeast Texas, specifically in Beaumont, Texas, and in Jasper, Texas. We'll check that out. It's good stuff. And we'll have the Southeast Texas debut of Brooke Graham's new video as our Taylor Trading Company music clip of the week from Nashville. Now, Brooke Graham is a singer-songwriter from Port Aransas area. Not bad song at all. Great visuals on this video, too. We can relate to, since we're here on the Gulf Coast in Southeast Texas. We'll also have the Honky Tonk Texas Fabulous Flashback with Cody Johnson. And my buddy Jeff Bates will be back in the Royal Spotlight thanks to Glenn's Express Collision. Here's a sample.
As I was writing this, what if I could just call my mom? And that's where the song came from. It's called If Heaven Had a Phone. I'd call it every day just to hear my mama's voice and let her know that I'm okay. And I'd tell her that I love her like I didn't get to do, 'cause I got there too late and she left here too soon. And I'd talk on and on if heaven had a phone.
Check out Jeff Bates on this weekend's Jim King of the TV show. And tonight on Strike TV, twice this weekend, or three times this weekend on Fox 4 and the CW. I'll be posting the segments at jimkingoftheroad.com and YouTube this weekend. So we're all over the internet and all over TV, streaming, you name it. We're doing it. And we appreciate you being here and riding along with us. Thanks for streaming King's Country at kingscountry.net. Some big happenings recently here at King of the Road Productions. We've just received a lot more airtime here locally in Southeast Texas. Coming out of Livingston, the station called Strike TV. You can go to striketv.com. They also have a Roku app, which is really cool. So you can stream it. It's high-quality stuff. You can stream it anywhere in the world if you just download the app. Strike TV Roku app. I'm just getting into the streaming world myself here on television. We recently got rid of our cable boxes and we're streaming exclusively at King of the Road Productions and at Suzanne Simmons' house, my lovely girlfriend. Anyway, don't miss it tonight at 8 o'clock. It's the latest Jim King of the TV show. Well, the one that aired last weekend. The brand new one will air Saturday night at 7 on Strike TV. But also on the CW Saturday morning at 6:30. And then Saturday night prime time on Fox 4. That's the big one. Sunday, 12 noon on the CW. Monday at 3 p.m. on Strike TV. Then Thursdays at 8 p.m. on Strike TV. 7 o'clock on Strike TV on Saturdays. Anyway, put it all in your memory bank because there will be a quiz. Not... Country, kingscountry.net, wrapping up a Thursday that feels like a Friday to me because it's crunch time, pretty much coasting to the weekend now. Got all my work done, all my projects are about to be turned in, the Jim King of the TV show, and the two church programs I turn in every Thursday. So keep it between the ditches, have a good one. Stay tuned for the most magnificent country music mix on the planet, 24/7 and 365. We'll talk to you for a TGIF mañana. Later, Gators.